Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I got an interesting email, not an Excel question at all, but an offer. This was an offer from a car company. Let's just say it's a planet that's sixth from the sun. Offered me a huge boatload of money to put a 20-second commercial in the Mr. Excel podcast every day for the next 2 months. A boatload of money. And I thought about that. I said, it's only a 1.5 to 2 minute podcast. We already have an annoying theme taking up 15 seconds at the beginning and the end. I don't want their money. So, good news, for the next 2 months, you're not going to have this annoying commercial, you're just having this one commercial. Help me out, come here to Mr. Excel, take a look at the Mr. Excel store. We have DVDs, we have books, you can get the live lessons DVDs, which are my whole Power Excel seminar for $39, cheaper than going to a seminar, cheaper than taking a day off, or the podcast DVD. Rather than me selling this podcast to someone else, let's just remember to stop by the Mr. Excel store every once in a while and contribute, and we'll be able to keep doing this for free. Now, yesterday, Steve sent in a question where he wanted to group this data by age ranges, and we used VLOOKUP. Now, this wouldn't solve Steve's problem, but it's related, and I want to talk about how we could do this with a pivot table. Let's say that Steve wanted to figure out the average time by each age group. All right, we can do that in either version of Excel, the old version or the new version, using a pivot table. We'll click OK. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the ages down the left-hand side in the row labels area, and then the times in the heart of the pivot table. And I want to change it from a count to an average. Click OK. And I get to see the average time for each individual item. Now, I should have, while I was in there, gone into number format and formatted it as an actual time. Good. Okay. Now, to very quickly group those items up, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go to the first age, right click, and choose group. Now, because this is a numeric field and not a date field, we get this version of the grouping dialog box. And I'm going to say I want to group from 0 to 70 in 10-year increments. And so what I get automatically is 0 to 9, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, and so on. Just a great way to figure out statistics for each age group without having to do a VLOOKUP like we did yesterday. Well, hey, there you have it. I want to thank Steve for sending in yesterday's question, and which also led to this podcast. Thanks to the car company, but no thanks. We'll let them keep their money. And remember to stop by the Mr. Excel store, check out our books, CDs, and so on. Thanks for stopping by. Have a great weekend. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.